ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృత దుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదం టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ prosperity, health, wealth and eternal happiness with paripurna lakshmi kataksams to you and the entire your family members. Let us begin Bhagavad Gita verse number 11 of 7th chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Balam Balavatam Asmi Kamaraga Vivarjitam Dharma Viruddho Bhoteshu Kamosmi Bharatarushabha. Now this physical five elemental world has been accepted as Ishvara. That's what the past few verses gave a clarity to set a perception. Even in Tamil Nadu, these five elemental aspects worshipped as a five lingas. In Kalahasti, known as Vayu Linga. In Tiruvannamalai, it's a linga which is in the form of fire, Agni Linga. In the Kanchipura, in the Ekambareshwara, which is Prithvi Linga. In Tiruvannakaval, which is in Tiruchi, known as Appu Linga, the water linga. And Chidambaram is the space. Akasha Linga. So these five elemental aspects given a form as a linga. Linga means the meaning itself, indication. That's the simplest meaning you can just realize. Linga means alambanam, a given a form which is rupa rupa. Because God doesn't have form, but still God alone exists in the form of. Therefore, you need to have a method where there is no rupa completely, where it is also absence of rupa completely. It's called a lingam. There is all these five elemental lingams, they are worshipped. It means what? Five elemental world alone is worshipped. And they are worshipped means what? The world has been given a perception, the tattva, the fact behind the creation is worshipped. The physical five elements and the original five elements together worshipped in that way. And all these intelligent causes, the intelligent causes means what? That which known as a subtle energies began from verse number 9 itself. Jivanam sarva bhuteshu tapaschasmi tapasvishu. Then also he said, bijam am sarva bhutanam vidhipartha sanatanam. Buddhi means intelligence. Buddhir buddhimatam asmi tejas tejasvi namaham. The brilliance of boldness among the bold people is me, courageous. The courage is nothing but me. When you realize this, you will get free from desire, likes and dislikes. Because life is nothing but dealing with likes and dislikes. If I ask a simple question, why do we have likes and dislikes? Do we have these likes and dislikes purposefully? Are likes and dislikes or the nature of the universe, we are kept in that? Because body, it is pulled towards certain things, likes and dislikes. Body has got likes and dislikes. Mind has got likes and dislikes. And our buddhi also has got the likes and dislikes. This is like, you know, we are swimming in the ocean which is nothing but likes and dislikes. But we give the priority as though I like, I dislike. Likes and dislikes is the nature of this universe. But if you want to get a kind of growth, inner growth and successful life, you should be careful with the likes and dislikes. This is the beginning level. Then you can find this world is free of likes and dislikes. Finally, these likes and dislikes are superimposition. Avidya karyam. You know, many people, maximum of people, don't like bitter gourd, but which is good for health. But they love sugar, which is not good for the health. Limited sugar, okay, but even though, so this white sugar should be avoided. Here in this verse, when you have a proper perception on the world as Ishvara, you will set the humility, because the strength which you have doesn't belong to you. Therefore, what? You will be endowed with the humility. You know how to lead the life being free from likes and dislikes. That's what he says. Kama raga vivarjitam balam ahamasmi. The strength which is free from desires, likes and dislikes, is me. But the people corrupt the strength because of their ego. Balavata means one who owns the strength. But the strength doesn't belong to kama raga. So both seems to be the same meaning. But there is a step. Kama means our desire for the materials, for the object which we don't have. It's endowed with longing, longing, longing. Raga means the object which we own, but having attachment with that particular object. Some people, they are addicted to their mobile. Not some people, all people. But certain varieties of mobile, certain company, certain brand, they are addicted. So addicted is a very strong word. But they love and they like the particular form of the car, particular varieties of the food, and even particular varieties of the workers they select. The desire with longing, desire with attachment. Our desire which is in the form of longing, desire which is in the form of attachment, both don't belong to strength. Strength means it belongs to Ishvara. Therefore, we should not corrupt the strength because of our likes and dislikes. And in the next line itself, he says, I am the desire. It's a final climax. I am the desire. Then what else we need? I need to have what? Pizza. So desire, nothing wrong, because Bhagavan is the desire. I want to kill the people. It's a desire. I want to loot the bank. It's a desire. I want to get land of others. Desire. Now I won't have the guilt feeling. Because I'm not guilty. Bhagavan has himself told, I am the desire. If he is in the form of the desire in all the creatures, nobody should bother about any dharma concept. Just whatever they want to have. Ranam krutva ghritam piba. Like Charvaka, one community was there long back. Still that community continues in different forms. They had the concept. They have a very clear understanding. Life is only dependent on this physical system. There is no other concept is required. Just live for your own satisfaction. Doesn't worry, take loans from outside and enjoy your life. Every day is the heaven. This is the heaven. And all the desire must be physical. Or what kind of the desires you get, you just fulfill it. It was the concept of Charuvakas. And now you can apply, who is Charuvakas. Suddenly you can also feel our mind is more depended on Charvaka's theory. Because we also think that this body alone is the life. We want also to enjoy the life. So Bhagavan Krishna, he supports all kinds of these desires. No, my dear, you have to see one word is kept as an adjective of this kamosmi. I'm in the form of desire in all creatures, but the desire should be not against dharma. Dharma aviruddha kamaha ahamasmi. I'm the desire which is not against dharma. Therefore, if a person follows dharma, he is endowed with Ishvara. When you go to Punya Yatra, when you go to a temple, when you construct the temple, when you do seva to the people, when you help the people who go for Pada Yatra, when you help to perform an yajna, all of them are desire. So automatically many people have the desire to perform lots of yajnas. I have seen brahmacharis who always, you know, performing japa, 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 always, because for them it's a feel fish in the water. They feel at home when they do japa. Not in order to escape from others, but they enjoy. The enjoyment attitude in the good way, in the positive way, it's known as dharma aviruddha kamaha. The desire which is not opponent to dharma. The desire I am. Therefore, even sadhu sannyasis, when they wanted to establish a schools or colleges, the great people, they have found so many institutions in order to serve the humanity. The desire is valued as Ishvara. Next verse. Echaiva sattvika bhavaha rajasastamasaschaye matta eveti tan vidhi natvaham teshu temayi. We have to remember all this knowledge about the universe. The first we spoke means Bhagavan has given complete knowledge how this creation had happened, who is the cause of creation, what kind of attitude which is backed by understanding we should observe. That's what is going on. Now he is touching the main body of the concept. He says he divides the whole being into three categories according to the characteristic gunas. There are three kinds of gunas: sattva guna, rajo guna, tamo guna. The people who are predominated by sattva guna are called sattvika bhavaha, sattvikaha, rajasikaha, tamasikaha. Sattvika means so dominant, the sattva characteristic people. Tamasikaha means so the people in whom this tamo guna is dominating. Rajasika means just rajo guna oriented people. That's what he says. Satrikaha bhavaha rajasaha tamasaha cha ye matta eva iti tan vidhi. So all these three characteristic, three gunas are out of me. There is a text, you know, which defines the Maya. Now he comes to the main topic of this Prakriti. You know, this Prakriti is the word that has to be realized well. In Viveka Chudamani, Acharya also says, Avyakta namni paramesha shakti hi anadya vidya trigunatmika para karyanumeya sudhiyaiva maya yaya jagaditam prasuyate. So this is entirely unique approach, because you cannot have research on the world, because world keeps on changing. Therefore, scientists, they struggle a lot to define anything, because it keeps changing. This is like a Gomukh. Gomukh is the originate place of Ganges, Ganga. Every time when you go, it's a different in a form, because all glaciers. So glaciers, when you go in the summer, so the glaciers, they, when they melt, in the morning there is one form, in the afternoon there is another form, in the evening there is another form. If you go in the rainy season, it looks differently. So therefore, this Gomukh means the place the Ganga comes from the mountain. It has got different forms. That is the nature of the Prakriti, my dear. I want to understand completely about the world. And some people, even, you know, good people means they also should be informed. When you get the desire, I want to serve this humanity. Why the humanity? I want to serve to all beings. It's a good desire. The desire itself is Ishvara. So that desire, be endowed with the desire, but you have to be informed the nature of the world. The nature of the world, how can be understood? Because world keeps on changing, and our system even, our mind, buddhi, body, complex, everything, they also keep on changing. So keep on changing means the changes even not visible. So slowly your face changes. And even, you know, this graying hair, my God, people are struggling to accept the fact. Therefore, you know, they have to depend on artificial blackening the things. We don't like changes. In some places, we like the changes. The change is the non-changeable nature of the creation. Then how to understand this creation which undergoes always modification? That is the secret. Our Upanishads, Bhagavan Krishna, all Acharyas, they have found a method to realize the complete nature and function and the characteristic of the Prakriti. It's a beautiful. The first name, Avyakta Namni, that which is known as Avyakta means, which remains always unmanifested, which never comes into the being. The secret, the potential power, which is known as Prakriti, it never comes into name and form. Therefore, it is known as Avyakta Vastu. And Brahman also Avyakta Vastu. What is the difference in it? No. The next word, Avyakta Namni Paramesha Shakti, is the power of Ishvara. Therefore, Bhagavan Krishna said, Daivi Hesha Gunamayi Mama Maya Duratyaya Mame Vaye Prapadyante Maya Metam Tarantite. So this Maya, which is known as Prakriti, is my power. So the people who surrendered, definitely they crossed that. This Prakriti is a unique phenomenon, which is not Sat, which is not Asat. You cannot say that exists. You cannot also deny that doesn't exist. Sannapya sannapya bhayatmika no bhinnapya bhinnapya bhayatmika no sangapya nangapya bhayatmika no Mahadbhuta Nirvachaniya Rupa. Mahadbhuta. It's, you know, it's amazing factor. It's an amazing truth. It's the nature of this Prakriti is very amazing. Therefore, he says, that's the power of Ishvara. Means what? The controlling point is nothing but Ishvara. Avyakta Namni Paramesha Shakti Anadya Vidya Trigunatmika Para, which is known as Anadi, beginningless. Avidya, which is in the form of ignorance. You cannot understand completely what the source of prakriti is. You cannot even define the prakriti. Have you ever thought before? Means 50 years before, everyone can get connected through internet, through mobile. So now mobile has got TV, radio, FM, internet, everything, even healthy products, market shops, malls, everything is connected with a small mobile. Have you ever thought? That's what Prakriti Tattva is. Who knows, after 50 years, every human can fly with a small equipment. We need not wait for 50 years. Everybody will travel in the air and all the traffic police also will be in the air. It's when you think, you know, because now there is no air traffic, much air traffic. Now these airlines will get confused because every individual will start flying. And some people will be sitting in the moon. If somebody asks, you know, what happened to you? Thoda sa bore ho gaya tha. I was bored, you know, a little bit. Then I thought, okay, I would come, you know, for a walk in the moon. Maybe possible. Prakriti. That prakriti, avidya maya prakriti, is completely ignorant to you, which can veil you. So the veiling capacity, it also has got the projecting capacity. Avidya means two kinds of capacity, veiling capacity and projecting capacity. Very simple example, when you see rope as a snake, now rope is veiled, snake is projected. From where? Does it from rope? No, from our buddhi. This prakriti, which can hide herself, mayaji. And don't take in wrong sense, okay? That same prakriti help us to live our life. Prakriti tattva. That prakriti tattva seen as a trigunas, okay? Sattva, rajas, tamo gunatmika, trigunatmika. Karyena eva anumeya. You cannot see her. When she comes, performs, you know, on the stage, world is the stage. After performance alone, you could realize, Haanji, Maya ji came and everything done, gone. This Maya is nothing but, you know, a kind of phenomenon. You can understand after the work is done, you know, after the mission accomplished, it can be done. It can be understood, ah, something happened. Therefore, you know, when people fight, after the fight, they say that, why? I was not aware, you know. I don't know how I spoke. Usually, I never become angry. But at that time, I don't know what happened. I spoke with my boss. Now, he has suspended on me. That's what prakriti, karyan, meya, suddhiya, eva. That too, people, you know, the well-informed people, viveki alone can realize her activity. That's what Bhagavan says, that trigunas have been launched as the prakriti. Therefore, these beings are having three kinds of characteristics. Sattva-guna oriented being, Rajoguna oriented being, Tamoguna oriented being. All of them are from me. Okay. Natu aham teshu temai. They exist in me. I am not existing in them. It means what? It's a confusing sentence. He says, the trigunas only can bind the people, not me. I am free from trigunas. But no creature, no being is free from trigunas in the creation. Creation means trigunas. That's what he continues. Tribher gunamayair bhavaihi ye bhesarvamidam jagat mohitam nabhijanati mame bhyaparam avyayam. He says, by these three gunas alone, whole entire creation is veiled, mohitam, that it needs lots of explanation and effort. So we will definitely understand the main core of Prakriti Tattva. Prakriti means the creation. When you want to understand the creation, the secret of creation, you should understand Maya Tattva. Maya Tattva is nothing but known as Prakriti Tattva. So Prakriti is called Maya. And the same Prakriti is also called Avidya. Don't get confused these words. So I am not confusing. So I will make you understand in simple way tomorrow in the next episode. See you. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.